Hi everyone, Dave Vellante here for theCUBE and theCUBE Research. You know, we spent the past 12 months dissecting how AI is colliding with data platforms. And one common thread is very clear that enterprises, they want to put intelligence right next to the data that they already trust. And they don't want to copy it onto another silo. And that's why Oracle's next database world, which is slated for May 7th in New York City, caught my eye. Oracle makes the claim that its 23 AI release folds Gen AI, vector search, JSON relational duality, and SQL firewall directly into the core engine. These are big promises from a big company, especially in a market where the likes of Snowflake and Databricks and Microsoft and AWS and Google are all jockeying to be the AI data hub. So I asked Maria Colgan, Oracle's VP of AI engines and mission critical data, to drill into what's real, what's the roadmap, and what can customers actually kick the tires on today. Maria, welcome. Thanks for spending some time with me.
Thanks for having me, Dave. I'm excited to be here.
Yeah, you bet. Okay, here we go. Another data platform conference. Maria, every vendor, they throw AI, you know, in their event banners, in their advertising. Give us the 30-second reason why, if I'm a hands-on DBA or a data architect, why should I carve out, you know, my time for this show?
I mean, for me, database world is that one event where the future of the Oracle database really comes to life. And during this edition where we're doing multi-cloud and AI, we're going to deep dive into some of those core capabilities that you talked about, AI vector search, JSON relational duality, and the impressive new SQL firewall. And we're going to do it by using a combination of technical sessions, as well as hands-on labs and interactive demos so that people can really get to grips with this, sharpen their skills, and also, of course, strengthen their data strategy going forward. So it really is a don't miss event for anybody in the New York region.
Yeah, a lot of deep experts are going to be there. You know, let's talk about vector search. So when I first saw, you know, the rise of vector search, and I said, well, is this a feature product? Is it actually a market? So you're basically bringing vector search inside of Oracle versus bolting it on. We talk about bringing AI to the data. So how is your vector index? How's it different? Say, for example, I plug in a Pinecone or a Milvus, which is open source on the side. What's different and better about your approach?
I think fundamentally the best part of our approach is the fact that it's not a bolt on or a separate system where you're trying to keep it in sync. We've brought AI vector search inside Oracle's converged data architecture inside the database. So it sits alongside all of your existing business data. So you can seamlessly integrate business data search with vector search in a very simple couple of lines of SQL, making it easy to implement with any existing application or any new applications that you're looking to build. And because it's inside the Oracle database, it gets all of the advantages that you know and love about your Oracle database. So all the data security capabilities, the high availability, and of course, all of the performance, because we are fully leveraging our Exadata platform to help accelerate those vector searches.
So let's talk about duality. I remember I first heard that term. I'm like, this is interesting, because I'm always saying that, you know, all this agentic isn't going to work unless you can harmonize the data. You've got structured data, unstructured data, SQL, JSON. So you're pitching your JSON duality my inference is it's sort of that harmonization platform and also a kind of a Mongo off ramp. Talk about both of those, if you could. Exactly what is duality and what's the migration effort specifically around, you know, Mongo?
So for sure, JSON duality is a very interesting spot for us, because traditionally, you know, developers or data designers always wanted to store things relationally to make it a very clean data set and all of that. But modern app developers are looking to have a very simple interaction with the database. They just want it to give them the info they need or send back the info they want to save. And so they prefer to do that interaction using JSON rather than a relational schema where they need to understand all the different tables. And what JSON relational duality views do is they bridge that gap. They allow the developer to interact with the database by simply asking for a JSON document, returning a JSON document with any changes they may have made. But under the covers or under the hood inside the database, we're leveraging all the power of a relational database by storing that information in tables so that we're getting all the power of the relational database, but with the simplicity of a document store. So really the best of both worlds is what you're going to get with JSON relational duality.
Okay, thanks
and
for that.
And of course, as you said, it is a great way for customers to offload themselves or get over from a document store like a MongoDB to the Oracle database, because it's going to allow their developers to continue to interact with the data store as if it was a document store, if it was Mongo, because we also have MongoDB compatible APIs that they can continue to use and leverage JSON duality views behind the scenes.
Got it. Okay, let's do the multi-cloud reality check. we like to call it, sometimes we like to call it super cloud. People don't like that term, but we're in a super cycle, super chips. So we love superlatives, but unlike some cloud providers, Oracle kind of likes the word multi-cloud. In fact, Larry Ellison at last year's Oracle Cloud World declared the era of multi-cloud has begun. We saw Matt Garman up on stage and said, wow, I can't believe it. This is a new era that we're entering, but you got things like egress fees, latency, you know, cross cloud complexity, you got to secure all this stuff. These cause customer pain. So my question is, which workloads, what's happening in the real world that are actually running on Exadata, on Azure, or OCI on AWS without network indigestion, I'll call it?
Yeah, I mean, I think that's the beauty of Oracle's multi-cloud solution is the fact that you're going to get exactly the same service, performance, reliability that you know and love about running Exadata in OCI. You now have the ability to do that on all the major hyperscale providers. So whether you have already made your cloud choice, and if that choice is Azure or it's Google Cloud or AWS, you're going to get exactly that same service over there from Oracle, running Oracle Database 23 AI on the Exadata infrastructure, but as a native cloud service in that cloud of your choice. So there's no moving data around. There's none of that ingress fees that you're talking about. All of that drama goes away because this is going to appear as a native service in your cloud of choice. And you'll get all of the benefits that you know and love from the Oracle database on Exadata. So really, it couldn't be simpler because you're going to pay for this using your existing cloud credits. All of that complexity just goes away. It's really a push-button solution for anybody looking to run mission-critical workloads on Oracle database.
So let's give us the bumper sticker. You know, where, when, how do people register? How much is it going to cost me to attend?
So the great news is this event is completely free. So I strongly encourage all of our customers in the New York region to join us on May 7th at the Convene, which is 360 Madison Avenue, for this completely free one-day experience. And they can go ahead and register by heading over to oracle.com/dbwnyc. And as I said, that registration is completely free, but space is limited. So folks really should do it today.
Excellent. We love freebies. Thank you, Maria. Appreciate your time.
No worries. Thanks for having me, Dave.
Yeah, you bet. All right. Let's put Oracle's claims to the test Wednesday, May 7th, and tell us what you think. If you're in the greater New York area and you want a no-cost, hands-on look at Oracle 23 AI, and you want to poke the tires, ask the tough questions, Oracle experts, they can go deep. So test them. They're going to be there. Grab a seat. Well, they're still available. Details are in the link below. We'll add that in. For theCUBE Research, I'm Dave Vellante, and we'll see you in the Big Apple. Go Red Sox.